Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In this video, we're going to have a look at creating selections in the sequence. There are a few ways in which you can create a selection. First, you have a simple click selection method. Simply click on a segment to select it. You can also hold down Command and click to add to that selection. To gesturally deselect a selection, there are three places you can click. You can either click below the audio tracks, the gap between the audio and video tracks, or the gap above the topmost video track. You can also select an entire track by clicking on the dimpled area of the specific track. If you wish to select the entire sequence, just press Command A. To remove all selections in the sequence with a keyboard shortcut, press Shift Command A. All the selections visible or not in the timeline view will be deselected. The next selection method is range selection using the positioner. So if you wish to make a selection in the sequence with the positioner, place the positioner on the frame you would like to start with, and press Command and drag the positioner either left or right. This will create a selection in the sequence with all the tracks. You can now lift or extract that selection out of the sequence for editorial reasons. The third selection method is rectangular selection. Without using any shortcuts, you can click and start a rectangular selection below the audio tracks. You can also use the gap between the video and audio tracks, or the gap above the topmost video track. If you try to start a rectangular selection over a segment or track without a shortcut, you will pick up whatever is under the cursor. To be able to make a selection from anywhere in the sequence, press Option W and then click and drag anywhere in the sequence. A rectangular selection is made, and then you can work with that particular selection. But one very interesting consideration is that you can control the selection behavior of the rectangular selection. There are, in fact, four types of behaviors that you can apply to a rectangular selection. To choose a rectangular selection behavior, go to the Timeline View Options menu and choose Rectangular Selection. So you have Bounded, Partial, Partial AV, and Inclusive. Each of the selection behaviors range from lenient to strict. Inclusive having the easygoing behavior and bounded being the strictest. The default selection behavior when starting smoke is inclusive. This selects everything inside the rectangular selection as well as any element that is touched by the rectangular selection box. So if I hold down Option W and drag a rectangular selection, everything in and around the area is selected. The next selection behavior is partial. Once again, with that option enabled, you can hold Option W to make the selection. This time, only everything inside the rectangular selection is selected. The section is defined from one edge of the rectangular selection to the other. So even if the segments were half in and half out of the rectangular selection, only the included portions are selected. For any of you wondering, the partial AV is the same as the partial behavior, except partial AV takes into account audio subframe editing. This is very rarely used, but it is there for those of you who venture in that direction. The last selection behavior is bounded, and it is the strictest behavior for a rectangular selection. When this behavior is selected, any rectangular selection will only select segments that fall entirely within the rectangular selection box. So if you're zoomed out of the timeline view and you start a rectangular selection using Option W, it will give you a little bit more accuracy with your selection. One last point about selections you need to be aware of is that gap clips in Smoke 2013 are currently always selected with the various selection methods. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.